Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Olga is here. For those of you who haven't yet, please subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell as well to get the latest notifications about the videos that I post out here for you guys. And for those of you who have been with me, I'm sorry I have to kind of repeat myself over again. This is for the new guys, for new subscribers. If you guys think I'm not looking into the camera, that's because I have a condition called optic nerve hypoplasia, and due to that I have nystagmus, and that's what's causing my eyes to shift ever so slightly, and that's why it might give you the impression as though I'm not looking into the camera, but I promise you I am looking into the camera. So with all of that out of the way, guys, today I am going to be talking about a very, very cool sampler kit that I just recently picked up at Sephora. If you refer to my previous videos when I share with you the recent purchases that I have made at Sephora, I picked up this wonderful kit right here, Belif Bestsellers On The Go Travel Kit. I have removed the products out of this beautiful square box because I have tried the products and I just lined them here in front of me so I can give you the specs on each and every product, and we can just kind of go through all of the products that are included in this set. I always have loved Belif for their moisturization creams. They have a beautiful cream such as this one right here. I have mentioned this countless times in my previous videos. I have been repurchasing this product and I have been using this product nonstop. This is part of my skincare routine in the evening. And of course, logically for me, I always have been curious about trying other Belif products. And I was like, maybe I should try them. But as you know, skincare that is really high quality, it is pricey. And sometimes you want to try the product and you don't want to spend a lot of money on one of the products to only find out that something doesn't work. So when I stumbled across this guy right here that includes 5 really luxurious samples, because you are getting quite a generous amount of product, and this is only for $20 at Sephora, I was really, really pleasantly surprised, and I was like, I am definitely going to try it, because I am a firm believer in being given the chance to try something in a format like this and then being able to make up my mind without being pressed into the thought that I have spent a lot of money on something, which makes it really hard to love the product if you're constantly thinking, oh man, this is so expensive, I can't believe that I just wasted all of this money. This is perfect because this gives me enough product to try without feeling that way. And I can tell you right now that after trying all of them, I do feel like these are fantastic products and you're actually getting substantial amount of product in them. So I'm going to attach the information to the side of me. As you can see from my previous video, I decided to kind of divide the screen into 2 halves and give you all of the specs on the side of the screen. That way, if I forget to mention something, you can refer to my notes over here and familiarize yourself with the specs of the products. So the first product that I have right here is the Deluxe Size Creamy Cleansing Foam Moist, and this product actually contains 30 milliliters. The funny thing is, I want to quickly mention this, when I was looking up the specs of the products, for some reason, on Sephora's website, they give different amounts. I am not sure as to why that is. So for example, on this product, I have 30 mLs of product or 1.01 fluid ounces. This is actually something that is printed on the product itself, but if you look on Sephora's website and you look up this product, these samplers, you will find out that from Sephora's website, they put it as 29.87 mLs. They still are telling you that it's 0.01 fluid ounces, but in the milliliters, it's not 30 milliliters, it's 29.87. So I'm not really sure as to why the discrepancy exists. My only speculation is that 29.87 mLs is actually more accurate, And I guess maybe the reason the manufacturer is putting 30 mls, they're kind of rounding it up, is because it's kind of looking prettier on the bottle than having all of these numbers. But that's purely a speculation. I don't know if that's actually the case. So that would be really cool to find out if that's the case. I don't know. So maybe the 29.87 mls is actually more accurate than 30 mls of product. I just wanted to quickly bring that up. I found that to be across the board with lots of the products and how Sephora lists the amount of product. So this is actually quite a generous amount of product you're getting. I mean, I have used this for the entire week and I still have a lot. And this is what it looks like. So when they're saying foaming, it's actually not something that I don't like is foaming, something that foams, you know, and I don't like foaming cleansers precisely because when you use a foaming cleanser, it tends to feel like your skin is stripped afterwards. It does feel squeaky clean. However, after a while, you feel really tight. But the point I would like to make is that it doesn't feel that way with this product. So with this product, my skin felt clean, but it didn't feel tight. And this is a huge plus. It is extremely hard to find a very nice, mild cleanser without that tight feeling that you get afterwards, which is actually not good because the tight feeling you get afterwards is actually telling you that your skin is not okay, that you have stripped your skin of all of the goodness and you really left it bare and you need to really quickly tone it and you need to moisturize it. This cleanser is actually wonderful because I felt clean afterwards. And yes, I did tone and I did moisturize and all of those steps, absolutely. However, I did not feel tight around my mouth. I felt very comfortable. And it does have a very nice, mild smell. I mean, it does have fragrance, but these products actually in this kit are, if they have natural fragrance, they do not have any artificial fragrance in them. So the other cool thing is that all of these products in this kit, they're made in Korea. And as we know, Korea makes pretty good skincare. So this is that cleanser. The next product that I'd like to talk about is the Bergamot Herbal Extract Toner. And this is a beautiful toner. I mean, this is, you know, typically what it looks like. So really clear, and again, has extremely mild, mild, fresh smell. It actually leaves your skin feeling really fresh. I loved using this. It just gave my skin such a healthy feeling. I really enjoyed that. So after this, I have the Hungarian Water Essence. This is a nice product as well, although for me, this was a little bit optional. I didn't necessarily know when to use it. I thought maybe I'm supposed to use this after the toner or before the toner. So that to me was not very clear. So I did use it after the toner and it was kind of optional. And I think that what I mean by saying optional is that you can use it throughout the day to moisten your face. I think it's just kind of like what I use by Caudalie, the grape water. And this is kind of that same thing. If you feel like your face needs that a little bit of moisture in it, that's the product to use. Absolutely fantastic product. The next product I have right here, so this is the Deluxe Size Moisturizing Eye Balm. And let me tell you, this actually has a very generous amount of product, 10 milliliters of product. This is fantastic. This is a very nice, very nice eye cream. I personally do not use eye creams simply because I feel like they are glorified moisturizers for your face and you pay a lot more for them versus like a regular moisturizing cream. But they do say that an eye cream molecular weight is less than in the regular moisturizer, because if you're putting like a very greasy, heavy moisturizing cream on your eyes, you tend to weigh down your eyes and bring that skin down, and we don't need any extra help because we already have gravity doing it for us. So that's why they're saying that the eye creams have a lesser molecular weight. Now, this is something I read and heard. This is not something I've necessarily checked on myself to say, oh yes, you absolutely have to use an eye cream, because I don't. But this is a nice one. So I would say this, if you can afford an eye cream, you might want to invest in something like this. It is very, very luxurious and very nice. And the smell of the product is just fantastic. It has a very nice, mild smell. It's not too much. It's not like you're getting a, whoa, this smells like roses, you know. You're not getting too much of the scent. And you feel like really refreshed after using this product. So the next product I have right here is the Deluxe Size, the True Cream Aqua Balm. So now this is different from the product that I use, because what I have right here is the True Cream Moisturizing Balm. So my product, the big jar that I have right here, is this is the moisturizing balm, and this is white inside. Now, this one that comes in the sampler kit, it has this slight bluish tint. I'm not sure if my lights are washing out the color, but this is a little bit kind of blue, you know, I don't know if you can tell, but it does feel extremely refreshing. This product right here, the Aqua Balm, is actually good for somebody with oily skin. Now, I don't have oily skin. However, the very first time I bought this product, I actually did buy this one, and I still loved it. But then I learned that this one, the moisturizing balm, the True Cream Moisturizing Balm, is actually for normal to dry skin, and I absolutely love it. So I'm okay using this product. Like if I had to swap, or if I accidentally picked up the Aqua Balm, I would be using it. It's not like, oh, it's, you know, it has to go back to Sephora. No, I would definitely use it. It's just that my preference goes for the moisturizing balm. So this is something that I've kind of learned. And of course, it's a personal preference. So whichever one works for you, and I would encourage trying them both, because this is a very personal preference. You might find that not necessarily the one for the oily skin works for you, but maybe for the dry skin. It all depends on your personal preference. I personally think that these products are fantastic. They're beautiful products. You are getting a ton of product for $20. A lot of times people say, well, don't spend your money on those samples, you're wasting money. That opinion has a valid point, however, to the certain point. Yes, you are maybe overpaying if you compare it to the gram weight per whatever per ounce you're paying. However, if you want to try a new product and you don't feel like spending $38 on a new cream, $42, $46 on one product, and you want to try a system, because this gives you a system of five products that you have like a schedule routine. You can be using this one after another and you have your system. I'm not trying to make it sound like a commercial right now. I'm sorry if it sounds like that, but I am very excited about this because this is a fantastic deal. So yes, I do think that sometimes, on a rare occasion, buying sampler sizes is actually a good thing. And I personally check that area all the time. I go to my JCP Sephora and I always check that area, and I know now why they keep us in lines. The longer we are in lines, the more of those little things we rummage through and get to see all of those little jars and little lipsticks. And that's how we get to learn and expose ourselves to trying new products. You can travel with it, and this is what I do love. If you feel like going with your whole big skincare routine, going to hotel, going through TSA, going through the airport. Now that's really a hassle because they don't allow liquids on the airplane. We know all of that. These are small travel size friendly products. So you absolutely can pop them in into your carry-on, and nothing will happen. You will not have to give them up at the TSA checkpoint. Now, this is something that also is in this little box. At first I thought that there is a product inside of it, but it's actually an empty little cube. Kind of looks like a soap bar. This is actually a nothing. I think it sits like this so that when your products are sitting in the bag, they are displayed better and they do not roll over the bag. So because this bag is a little bit larger for these sample sized products, and so that's why I think the company has included this little thing in here. Personally, I think it would have been kind of nice if they had included some sponge or some sort of applicator, because I just feel like it's a little bit of a waste of space. In a sense, I understand why they put it there, because they wanted to make the other products visible, but I think they could have included something. I don't want to say please put a piece of soap in here, because a soap is a no-no for the face, I know that. It's very drying, but maybe some kind of a little sponge, just like a little kind of a quick suggestion. Tiny itsy bitsy little criticism. Other than that, yes, I do believe that these are fantastic products, and yes, they are Olga Guffey approved, because I have used them, I see improvements. And on a quick note, something else I want to discuss. As I have been using these products, I have noticed significant improvements in the texture of my skin. Don't look at it now, this is all full face of foundation, so this is a very bad example of showing you. I am not bare skinned right now. However, this is what I can tell you. How I used to perceive what the dry skin is versus what the dry skin actually looks like. Because when we hear the term dry skin, what is it that we usually think about? We think of, or at least what I think about, maybe other people think differently on dry skin, but usually I think of dry skin as kind of scaly, uneven texture, really dry, very sore. Usually I think of hands as dry skin, or maybe elbows, and especially during the winter time when we have the forced heat in the houses. Now, I live in Washington State, so this is not Cali or anything like that, or not Florida, you know, but we do have forced heat in the house, and of course it is very drying to the lips, very drying to the skin. Now, when I used to think of dry skin, I was really thinking about some kind of eczema or something that looks like white patches on my, or cracked skin on my hands, and I would know to put moisturizer on my hands. Now, a couple of times I had gone to the dermatologist this past year, and I had gone there because I had some skin tags that needed to be removed, never mind. But I also had shown him different areas on my skin, and I would say, well, look at this, doctor, this looks really different, my knee, the skin just doesn't look right, and it's not itching, and it's not painful, but it looks weird. And then right here on my face, I have some kind of a dark spot, but again, it's not painful, it's not itchy, it's not a pimple. And he would look at all of these different areas on my skin, and he would say, this is dry skin, this is dry skin, this is also dry skin, and this is dry skin as well. And all of those spots looked different to me. And I was like, really? How can it be dry skin? And he was, of course, saying apply Vaseline to the knee or to your elbow or this and that. And he also explained that dry skin can present itself differently. It doesn't look like what I had a vision in my mind of what the dry skin looks like. All of these different issues I showed him were dry skin. And as I'm working with my face and trying these beautiful products, I started noticing those problems going away. I'm not saying that every single problem that ever anybody has on their face is due to the dry skin, but what I can tell you is that this is how it started, probably. And I'm not saying eczema or psoriasis is dry skin. I'm talking about healthy skin that is just dry. You know, there could be some pigmentation spots, there could be some dead skin cells that never have exfoliated properly, and the skin didn't go through that proper turnover of itself, you know, didn't heal itself properly. But all of these things will present themselves, and on me, they looked different. I had different things going on. Each time I go in, he says, this is dry skin. Where all roads lead to Rome, we need to moisturize. As soon as we start hydrating our skin, taking plenty of water, moisturizing, then I'm not saying every problem will go away on the face, but a lot of these problems will, and a lot of other problems will improve. The point I'm trying to go to is that this particular set right here is an excellent set if you are suffering from dry skin. I am suffering from dry skin. I used to say, well, I have normal skin. I have normal skin. No, no, I have dry skin. And a lot of times it has to do with the water intake, something very important that many of us neglect. So it's the water intake plus good skincare routine, moisturization. And in fact, if the skin is nice and moist and enriched with hydration, it will receive the foundation and any other powders, makeup, contouring powder, highlighting powder, everything will lay nicer on the skin if it's moisturized properly. With all of that said, guys, thank you very much for tuning in. Please give this video a thumbs up. If you have any product in mind that you would like me to review, please let me know in the comment section down below. Sound off if you have any questions, if you have tried these products, what were your thoughts and experiences with them. So I encourage the conversation. Let's go ahead and start those juices of the conversation flowing and exchanging the info. If you want me to review something, do let me know. And I do have some of the new stuff that I got that I will be reviewing on this channel. I have a new VZ Art palette that I'll be reviewing. I have some Melt Cosmetics eyeshadows that I'll be reviewing. And all of that good stuff. So do stay tuned. If you are new to my channel, you are welcome. And if you aren't yet, please subscribe to my channel. And I will see you all in my next video, guys. I love you. Bye.